plunge the lotus feet of our most beloved Bhagavan. Welcome to all of you for this morning session. To the extent I remember, few questions have not been answered last week. About 7 questions have been successfully answered, if I am right, and few are left unanswered. If I do not take them up, it will give a wrong signal that I am trying to avoid. I don't avoid, I would rather say, excuse me, I don't know. But I don't want to give you any kind of misapprehensions like that. I got the list with me. We will...
Sir, what happened?
The list with me, we'll go ahead with those questions. In addition to that, I got fresh lease of questions to be dealt with this morning. Life is full of questions, yes. A time when we reach a state that all questions stand answered, when all doubts come to a standstill, with His grace in this onward journey, we are really lucky. We'll be working towards that. Certainly come forward with all your questions. I welcome you. Why? These question answer sessions are like any other talk. They're all filmed, they are recorded. All this will be put in the website saiwisdom.com. As far as the information goes, about 1,000 people every day visit that website. And it's spread all over the world, and about 65 people are working for it, and available in 13 international languages. So when you put a question, all of them will be benefited. All of them will read, and they will send back their own questions. When we discuss these things, we'll have some sense of satisfaction. In the process, some of our own doubts get cleared. It is with that idea, with your permission, I go ahead. We completed 7 questions last time. Now I start with the 8th question. Because Swami has left His body, is it fair on our part to celebrate Diwali this year? Is it fair on our part to celebrate Diwali this year as Swami has left His body? This question has not been put without a background. I don't dismiss the question. It has got a background. As far as the Indian tradition, as well as some of us Hindu tradition, because of the demise of a member of the family, they do not celebrate any functions for 1 year. Until the first anniversary is over, they don't celebrate any functions. And some don't visit temples also. They don't do any rituals. This has been a tradition or a convention which is practiced. Left to me individually, with ill will to none, good will to all, I have no faith in this. And I don't observe any rituals. So, that's my individual life. Let me come back to the question. For 1 year, we don't celebrate because of the demise of a member of the family. shall we celebrate Deepavali or not? Genuine question. I really appreciate the questioner for having taken Swami as a family member. The loss of a family member will not permit me to celebrate any grand function. I appreciate him for having taken him as a family member with all the attachment, love, affection and concern. But my answer is this. Bhagwan Baba is not comparable to any family member. When a family member is gone, out of sight, out of mind, we don't see them anymore. We don't see them anymore. But Bhagwan Sri Satsai Baba is no doubt a family member, no doubt closer than a family member, yet he is you and you are Swami. You and Swami are one. So I cannot say that he has left me because I have not left myself. So long I am alive, my God is in me. My God is with me because he is in me. So I cannot accept the concept that he left. Point two, we know Swami manifesting all over the world today. Somebody tells me Swami appeared. Somebody tells me, sends me a mail, I experience Swami. People talking to us, vibhuti flowing, honey flowing from all over the world. Perhaps Bhagwan Baba, sir, please help. Sir, please put him in a chair there. Thank you, thank you. So the position is, he is manifesting, he is showing his divinity all over the world more than before. In that case, how can I say he left? No. Moreover, Rama is not here amongst us. Don't we celebrate Sri Rama Navami, the birth of Rama? Krishna is not physically available. Don't we celebrate Krishnashtami? Christ is not physically available. Don't we celebrate Christmas? Why? Because avatars, they don't leave us. They drop the body, that's all. But they are with us. But they will get the body and give individual appearances depending upon the intensity of our feeling, the gravity of our devotion. They do appear when they want. And life with an avatar is a celebration. We don't have to wait for Diwali. Every moment of life is a festival. Every day is a celebration with Swami. So don't have any other feeling. Celebrate Diwali more prayerfully, in constant remembrance of the light of Diwali, of the lamp of Diwali, which represents himself. The light of lights is the delightful Bhagavan Baba. So, and that light represents a center of concentration. That light represents a feeling that it is the light which is the knowledge, taking us out of ignorance. So Diwali is the fittest celebration, not anything like abstaining from the observance of the festival. Please carry on. Next question. What kind of pujas can we do for Swami now? Is there any guideline according to Vedic scripture? This question is also from a person who is highly traditional and an orthodox also, who follows the rituals and the family tradition scrupulously. Because we have special pujas marking the demise of our people. We have special rituals marking the first anniversary of those that left us. My friend, all these are applicable to mortals, human being only. Why? Because God has no beginning to have an end. So the one without beginning and end is God. So there is no question of special pujas for the end. On the other hand, puja means worship. There cannot be ordinary worship, super worship, special worship. No, worship is worship. In fact, true worship is emulation of, copying, imitating the noble qualities of the one whom you worship. If you worship Christ, there is no point in telling, "Oh Lord, you are compassionate." Yes, Lord is compassionate. You are not giving him any conduct certificate. He is not specially compassionate this morning, Sunday. No. Christ is compassion. Compassion is Christ. Sacrifice is Christ. Christ is sacrifice. Love is Christ. Christ is love. Forgiveness is Christ. Christ is forgiveness. So when I say, "Oh Lord Jesus, you are really a forgiving Lord," then he will laugh. Is it a discovery? Is it an invention? Is it anything new? Are you telling me anything that I was not till now? At least I appreciate you have recognized it today. Though late, better late than never. Therefore, my friends, true worship is emulating, copying the noble qualities of those whom we worship. When you worship Baba and hate everybody, your worship is a ritual. When you love everybody, it is a true worship. So worshipfulness is the strict following of the essential teachings and the principles of those whom we worship. So there is no special puja. The puja becomes special when we follow the significance of puja. Then comes next question. There is still a great dilemma about yag being a vegetarian dish or non-vegetarian dish. Someone said, "We can eat unfertilized eggs. How will we know?" Maybe this question, I suspect, the gentleman is interested to have eggs and is trying to find an excuse how to have some divine license to take it. Instead of avoiding egg, while thinking of egg, better you eat. Because this egg has become a mental obsession. Egg, can I eat? Egg, should I eat? Egg, vegetarian or non-vegetarian? Instead of that, better you finish it off. No problem. Then that's the end of the first consignment of questions I had. This morning, I received by mail some more questions. Good, because all this will go in one session and thereby to the website subsequently, benefiting all the viewers as time passed by. Now, here are some important questions which are quite relevant to all of us. This is the question. Is it important to be a member of the organization to serve Swami? This question may be from a brother who is feeling uncomfortable in the organization, or maybe from a brother who finds it difficult to serve being in the organization, or to the one who could not proceed with service because of the organization. I tell you my views on this. Baba is not a member of the organization, but is serving everybody. There cannot be anybody who can serve more than Sai Baba. And Sai Baba is not a convener of any Sai center or president of any Sai center, not even a Bhajan Mandali convener. He has no position, poor Swami. But he does service a lot. So taking Swami as an illustrious example, I can say service first, organization next. And second, then why organization? Organization is an association of like-minded people. On Sundays, when all our friends of the organization go for service, we are also tempted to go. When all our friends do selfless service, we are attracted to join them. So, organization is fellowship, organization is friendship, organization is a company of like-minded people. Then, when we work together, we can complete work within a stipulated time. When we work together, we can certainly undertake bigger projects, wider projects, larger projects, serve more people. You can serve more people. You can undertake wider areas of service. Therefore, organization will help you to serve more, to reach the unreached, to extend the frontiers of your service, to widen and expand your service projects. So, organization helps you, promotes you, catalytic. Catalytic, it serves as a catalyst. So, service first, organization next. Organization will help you to serve better, to serve more. Therefore, organization and service are complementary and not contradictory. One is the corollary to the other. Therefore, we are not confronting, but we are supporting each. Next question. About leaders. It is important for the leaders to change themselves first. As per Swami's message, love and selfless service. Leaders must change themselves. Then judge others. Then judge others. This is the second question. There are two parts here. The first part, leaders themselves should follow the message of love, service, whatever Bhagavan stands for. Why leaders should follow? Everybody should follow. To say that leader should follow, meaning you are keeping him above you. A leader is not above anybody. He is also a human being. He has not fallen from heaven. He is not an angel. He is also as weak as anybody, as strong as anybody. So, in respect of devotion, in respect of self-purification, from the point of selfless service, love, fraternity, service and all that, we cannot expect leaders only to follow. In fact, many leaders don't follow. As we look at them, we understand, if we also stop following, one day we too may become leaders. Since we are following, we are not able to become leaders till today. No promotion, nothing. Continue to be same position. Not elevated to the district level, not promoted to the state level, rotting same old. If I stop following, immediate promotion. My friends, let's not bother about leaders. I have not come to the organization because of the leader. Leader is not the center of attraction. All of us should know one thing. There's only one leader, Bhagavan Sri Satsai Baba. He is the only leader. Why? He does what he says. He says and he does. What he feels, he says. What he says, he does. This is Trinity or Triputi or three in one or harmony or unity of thought, word and deed. He is the only one. Somebody said, there is only one Christian, only one Christian, by name Jesus Christ, who died on the cross. Because he followed, he could not continue his life. So my friends, leaders, they are just communicators. Leaders are communicators. Leaders are facilitators. They need not be role models, champions of human values. Then we can worship our leaders themselves. Baba is not needed. Every center president is Baba. We don't do that. So kindly do not expect any extraordinary qualities in them. It is enough if they are not negative. It is enough if they don't block our way. It is enough if they do not discourage us. It is enough if they do not bring bad name to the organization. That is enough of leadership. Because our leader is Baba himself. The second part of the question is, follow and judge others. This also I have an objection. The one who follows will never judge. The one who does not follow always judges. Why? Jesus Christ, while passing by, he saw an incident. In those days where there is breach of discipline, breach of conduct, one is stoned to death, stoned to death. No hanging, no shooting, no electric chair to conveniently be transported to the other planet. It's not like that. They'll be stoned to death. That was the punishment in those days. A woman who disobeyed the norms of the society is being stoned by people. She was to die. Jesus was passing by. He saw that this cruel thing. He stood there and said, look here. You are punishing her. Okay. Now tell me, who has not committed any sin? Let him throw the stone. Let her throw the stone. The one who has not committed any sin can stone her to death. Come on. Nobody came forward because no one is above board. Human we are. Everybody left. Then Jesus says, O woman, you are forgiven. Go forth, thy woman. Sin no more. You are forgiven. And then Jesus tells her, look here, I have not committed any sin. Those that committed sins left. I have not committed any sin, but I don't judge you. I don't punish you. Therefore, no one has any right to judge anybody. Who are you? I give my own example. Long back, say 40 years ago, I was in the auditorium, Purnachandra auditorium. All devotees are clapping. Whenever Swami says something, an important declaration, I said loudly to my friends, why these people clap like that? Is it cinema hall or what? What is all this? Can't they observe silence? I said. After 15 minutes, Swami made another statement. I'm the first fellow to clap. Just then I said, don't clap. But I was the first fellow to clap. What does it mean? What you judge today will come back to you. Because the Holy Bible says, judge not, lest thou shalt be judged. If you judge, you will be judged tomorrow. We have no right authority to judge anybody. Because you may be guilty of the same guilt tomorrow. Who knows? Therefore, my friends, let us not judge. Let us not be leaders, but only facilitators, but only communicators. Third question. A question, if you are a normal worker, this word is used, normal worker. If a senior objects you, what should you do? If I oppose, is it wrong? A normal worker, if he is objected to do some good work by the seniors, if he opposes, is there anything wrong? This must be a question from a victim. This must be a question from a person who is dominated by somebody else. This is the question from a person who is not allowed to express his opinion. He is forced to protest. But the non-Sadh organization, love for Swami, made him silent. Now he feels, what is the wrong if I object? In the interest of the organization, what does Baba say about it? Baba said, we cannot argue and counter-argue. You cannot protest or raise slogans or see that one is out of power by taking up no confidence motion, as in parliament, democratic society. No protest like that. So what shall I do? We can meet our seniors privately, separately, when they are alone. Talk to them convincingly, softly, sweetly, so that he will understand your position. He will understand your view patiently, sympathetically. If the other man is convinced you are interested in the organization, he will give you a patient listening. If the other man feels that you are there only to oppose, you are making Sai Center a house of parliament. Therefore, my friends, we can protest, we can oppose, but these two words are negative. Protest is a negative connotation. Oppose is a negative expression. We'll use that. Let me share my view with you. Let us share our views with others, then oppose other views. Talk convincingly, separately. That is the way, rather taking up on a platform, in a forum, which is not admissible. Yes, next question. As a worker, what should I do when office bearers are wrong or biased? Naturally, the question must be from a member of the organization also. Only. Why? When I point out when he is wrong and biased. One possibility. Second possibility. If I keep quiet, knowing that he is wrong, committing some mistake, if I keep quiet, does it mean that I am not doing work of Swami? Should I say yes to everybody? Should I like all the likes of the office bearers? Should I dance to the tune of likes and dislikes of office bearers? What should I do? Really, these are all very sensitive questions. But my friends, where there is a love, these problems will not arise. In our family, do you mean to say that we are open and free? The eldest son says, "Mother, your love youngest." The youngest fellow will say, "Father, you love the eldest." Both the sons will come and say, "No, no, she being the only daughter, you love her only." So children feel that we are prejudiced. Children will feel we are biased. So even in the family, we are not free from criticism or attack. It begins with family, most probably. Most probably. Shall I dance with the likes and dislikes of my seniors? The husband may say, should I dance as per the likes and dislikes of my wife? The wife may say, why should I dance as per your likes and dislikes? This is the age of women's liberation. You understand me? You dance, I don't dance anymore. We have danced enough for centuries. It is time for husbands to dance. Why not? Why not? My friends, this is just give and take. When I just accept what you say, though I do not like, next time you care to know my opinion, try once Instead of saying, I don't like, no, stop it. Just to follow. Next time he will ask you, he will consult you. But only thing is, we are not patient enough. We want whatever we say must prevail upon. We want what we say. If there is anything contradiction, we prefer to protest loudly. No. In a family, are we not going together with all our likes and dislikes? Take for example TV. Kids want to see Pogo, children programs. Ladies want to see TV serials where there is a lot of opportunity to cry. Cry. They go on crying. And we too have to cry in chorus. And gents want to follow the news 24 hours. I am no exception. I want to follow news, regional, national, international, always. So, three sets of people. Pogo gang, serial gang, and news gang. All the three together make a nuisance in the hall. Because children will shift, and with the remote you change. She shouts, will silence both. Likes and dislikes. Out of the two sons, one likes the sweet. The other son likes the hot. She wants this to be made for lunch. He wants now this is to be made. Is not mother an excellent manager? If I am to give MBA, mother should be given PhD in MBA. Not master of business management. Every woman is a master of man management. Any woman can manage the man in an excellent way. Yes. If the man goes on saying, nothing doing, she won't oppose him, she will wait. He will wash his feet, he will change his dress, have one cold water, glass of water, sit relaxed at the dining table. She starts serving item after item, very interesting items. Then she will say, shall we do that? She will say, yes, why not? The useless fellow said no. The same fellow says, come on, do it right now. Meaning she knows when to ask, how to ask, finding the moods of the husband. So also husbands also know the technique to please their counterparts, the wives also, how to cool her and all that. This house management, family management, are we not doing it successfully? If we are not doing it successfully, would not have continued as a family unit, would have been apart already. We are still continuing. Our views have not changed. When one wants money, the other one does not want money. One wants a fully furnished grand gala house, the other one says, hut is enough for me. What to do? But are we not living together? We are. How and why? Because of love. Out of the two, one is talkative, one is silent. One is active, the other is passive. You know, you'll enjoy this thing because it's true with everybody. If anyone says, oh, I'm active, she's active, she's the gas number one. I am not here to accept it. We do have long innings in the marital family, marital status. So, perhaps, to maintain the balance, God created couples of paradoxical nature. paradoxical nature, ironic expressions, polarities of opposites. Intentionally he did it. The two wires, one is plus, other is negative. Allow the current to flow. Why not two plus wires? Forget the electricity. So even in electricity, opposites work. And in some places, they have tap fittings in their restrooms. Two taps, hot water, cold water, opposite. You think elsewhere and allow the hot water flow, take the skin out of it. That also happens. Opposite. Chili powder, salt, opposite. Coffee decoction, sugar and milk, opposite. Tell me where two are completely identical? No. Parvati stays in Himalayan range of mountains, Kailash. Husband Shiva is moving around the burial grounds. What to do? And Parvati loves all the jewels and lovely silk saris, wonderful border and all that. Husband Shiva is a naked man with no dress at all. No jewels, only ash. Ash, vibhuti. That's all. No jewels, nothing. She has got a crown and all that. Lord Shiva has snakes around his neck. She has got status as a lion, the tiger has her chariot. Husband Shiva has bull as a chariot. But are they not ideal gods? Ideal couple? They are ideal couple, just opposite. So let us not worry that we differ with each other at the family level, no. We belong to Shiva's family, progeny of Lord Shiva. So this has to go like that. This has to go like that. Therefore, my friends, we can accommodate our likes and dislikes. We can support each other. We can understand the areas where we differ. There's a beautiful phrase where you can say that politely. Let us agree to disagree. Let us agree to disagree. No fight. Therefore, even in the organization, if you love Swami more, you'll be able to accommodate. Where there's ego, there's a clash. Where there's pride, there is a rift. Where there is selfishness, there is a quarrel. So quarrels, fights are all due to selfishness, ego and pride. Simple example. How Baba is able to tolerate all of us? First, if at all you want to pity anybody, first pity Baba. Please sympathize him. Because he is tolerating all of us. None of us follow him. Baba is a complete failure in not making us successful to follow his teachings. We are successful in not following his teachings. He is a failure by not making us follow his teachings. But he still loves us. The child may play on the ground with the sand, and some sand, the child may just throw it on the head. The child may spoil the clothes. The child body is dirty. But mother loves the child. Mother lifts the child to her arms. Why? Love. Mother's love does not depend upon the ironed clothes of the child. If the child sits like that, with ironed clothes, not spoiled, then mother will take the child to a child specialist. Some people come and tell me, Sanju Kumar, my children are mischievous. Then I always tell them, if the child is mischievous, in adulthood that child will be disciplined. If the child is disciplined now, problem starts there. If you are indisciplined in the adulthood, amma, horrible, terrible. Better we complete our mischief in our childhood. So don't worry. If the child goes on jumping around, we like it. We may shout. Suddenly when grandson or granddaughter, they leave the family, youngest child, then the whole house is empty. You are left with nobody to shout at. Whom do you shout? If you go on shouting still, you'll be taken to a psychiatrist. So you cannot, you have no one. Then you'll say, I am not able to spend time without my grandchildren. When the grandchildren are around, I am shouting, lose my energy. When they are not there, I am not able to spend time. That is paradox of life. Those that live in cities like Washington, Chicago, San Francisco, the very, very busy cities in US or London in UK, very busy cities, they feel like staying in a hamlet or a village, very, very peaceful. If we ask the villagers, when will I go to a city, enjoy city life? So the mind is always towards the opposite. When you have money, you will feel, what is this money is giving me? Let me have peace of mind. The fellow with peace of mind will say, when will I have money? That is the mischief of the mind. It's not our fault. Therefore, likes and dislikes are mind-oriented, are mind-based. So never mind. And if this mind, which you cannot control, there are some people say, I have control of mind. Is the first man who has no control at all. 0%. Why? I have control mind. I, that is the mind. Finish, 0 marks. So it's not easy to control the mind. Can you control the waves? Waves of the ocean? If any fellow says, I control the waves of the ocean, of the ocean, oh, waves? Good. Please tell somebody who are yet to be born. You can't fool all for all times. Can you prevent leaves without fluttering? No. Leaves naturally flutter. Waves upsurge. You cannot stop them. Natural. Mind thinks. Mind is full of thoughts. One thought will make you very happy. Next thought, very unhappy. One thought, it thinks of enemy. Next thought, your dearest, your friend. One thought, your success. Next thought, your failure. In the meantime, sun rises. The whole night is this. Thoughts, counter thoughts. Thoughts, counter. If you are able to control the thoughts and counter thoughts, which is not in your hands, which is not possible, what shall I do? Baba gave the answer. Because he knows. What he said is this. Circus. Have you seen circus? Some must of you. In our younger days, circus was main center of attraction. Jimni circus, Parashuram circus. There is no circus today. Because we have become objects of circus. We don't need special circus. Our life has become a circus. Family has become enough of circus. So, in circus, what happens? All wild animals will be there. The tigers and lions. The ringleader, ringmaster of the circus will be able to control the wild animals. If the ringmaster is not there, if the fence is not there, we become their lunch and the dinner. That happens. When ringmaster is there, highly disciplined, otherwise not. Similarly, mind is a circus. Full of wild thoughts, full of wild, cruel, harmful, animalistic views and thoughts. How to control them? Ringmaster, Bhagavan Sri Satsai Baba. Bring him there. He will control your thoughts. He will control your thoughts. When once ringmaster Bhagavan Sri Satsai Baba is there. That's why we sing Manamohana Nandanar. Manamohana. You know that song? Manamohana Madhusudana Brunda Pananandala Manamohana Nandala. Manamohana meaning you sing smiling, but Manamohana ringmaster. Mana. Therefore, when you sing like that, when you pray to him, the ringmaster will take charge of all these wild animals of thoughts. That is the way to control them. There is no other way. If somebody told me, I cried and cried and cried at a time when I had bad thoughts and I came out of the bad thoughts. Then I tell him, you came out of the bad thoughts, good. You are going to enter into much worse thoughts. Because you cannot. It's not in your hands. Mind is in his hands. How do I say that? Simple example. During bhajans, if we are very sincere, sing loudly. There is no possibility of any thought in the mind. No, sir, during bhajans only I get thoughts. Then stop bhajans. If you are really active in bhajans, these thoughts have no place. Simply how? While I am talking, I cannot have other thought. If I have got my thoughts related to the kitchen, I'll say it's time, let us wind up. If I have thoughts relating to my class, I start speaking botany but not satsang. So while speaking, there is no other thought. Because while speaking, I am in constant concentration with complete focused attention. That's what bhajan is. Not that God is interested to listen to your melodious voice. Even the neighbors are not able to bear it. House owners and landlords have given you notice to quit, being not able to bear with your hoarse voice. But still we sing. Why? For the mind to be fresh, to drive out thoughts. Those that sing Baba's bhajans or Christian hymns or any song in praise of God, they will be very healthy. They will be always smiling. They have nothing to cry, no reason to cry. They will have support of God. When I call you by name, you will be there immediately. Is it not? I call you by your name. Yes, sir. Don't you say that? Similarly, in bhajan, we call God by name. And he will say, yes, sir, I am there. Baba is at your doorstep waiting for your call. Calling bell may fail. phone calls always fail. It will never reach. But Baba waiting at the doorstep, he himself said, I am your servant. I am your servant waiting at the door. Why? You may call me any moment. I am ready to serve you. Therefore, my friends, to develop this equanimity, steadiness, balanced state of mind, consciousness. Supposing we fought with each other. You used all bad words to me. How can I swallow all the insult, shame, blasphemy, character assassination? How can I take it up? Shall I fight with you? Or bring some lorry load of rowdies to beat you? Or sharpen my knife, finish you tonight? I'll take some guns. In Africa, I was told, they have got license given to anybody, even students also. So if a teacher asks a question, shut up. So better I'm not a teacher there. So what shall I do? I react. Who react? Those that feel very happy in praise, we feel unhappy in blame. When you blame, I feel so bad. Why? I feel very happy when I'm praised. But in respect of Baba, praise him, that's all. You criticize him, he's not at all bothered. So many newspapers have written against him. So many people spoke against him. Millions of people worship him. He is not disturbed by their worship or their blame. Because those that worship him may change their political party today, join that group, when interview is not given. When their desires are not fulfilled, those that worship may condemn him tomorrow. Those that condemn him today, when doctors give up all the hopes that this fellow cannot survive, when someone comes and tells him, there is one such Sai Baba, pray to him, he will be all right. Amma, he changes his political party, joins this gang. So our praise and blame is just an opportunistic mentality. It is just a bargain. It is commercial. It is business. But God is beyond blame and praise. Therefore, when I sing in praise, what happens? Just like God, who is above praise and blame, my mind is also above praise and blame. My mind is also above pain and pleasure. Meaning, God is non-dualistic. When I sing in praise of him, my mind becomes non-dualistic. Then I am happy. Therefore, my friends, very easy key Baba has given. But we don't want it. Come on, sing Baba bhajans. Your blood pressure will never increase. But we don't sing. Because we go on fighting with everybody. Therefore, there are many doctors. In those days, there were not many doctors. You know that? Very few of them. Today, every street has a doctor. Every locality has super speciality hospital. Because we are fighting in a super level. When once we stop fighting, when once we stop quarreling with each other, when once we sing his praise, nothing, no enemy can disturb you. No failure can disturb you. No birth or death can disturb you. Because bhajan is equanimous. Bhajan is sacred. Bhajan should be our bhojan, the main food. Therefore, my friends, my answer to this is this. I have just two more. I'll send you soon. Is God the doer, as many people say, or is he with them or something like that. Huh? With?
Witness.
Oh, witness. Oh, good. Oh, wow. You are from?
Netherlands.
Good. But this, the question speaks of the standard of the questioner. Hats off to you. God bless you. Very good question indeed. God is not the doer. The question is God a doer or a witness? Right? My answer is this. God is not the doer. He is the witness. Then who is the doer? Are there two? Am I clear? When once you are inward, you are the witness. When once you are outward, you are the doer. Means, when once sun rises, daytime. When once sun sets, night time. Same sun. Right? Or we have one sun for the day, one sun for the night. I may have two suns in laws, but not noon, two suns. Same sun. Similarly, the mind, when it is outward, is the doer. Because the outward mind, extrovert mind, external mind, worldly mind, together with the senses, interact. Then this mind is ego. That some people say, I have done that, I am that, This I is the doer. I, some people say, what is your son doing? Oh, well, I got him educated. Shut up. You got him educated? Shut up. You yourself is not sufficiently educated. How do you take the credit for your children? Nonsense. But because of courtesy, we simply, Father, they know not what they do, forgive them. So my friends, this doership is ego. Doership is extrovert mind. Doership is identity. Doership is separate entity. Doership is because of the present life. In consequence to the results of the actions of the past life are karma phala. The present life is the result of consequences of the actions of the past life. All this is recorded in the mind, software. This DVD software, with all the samskaras, the consequences of the past life, are put here in the present body, the hardware. Hardware is the present life. Software is the past life. So, we act like that. Now what I have to do? Wear and tear. I do wear, I can't help it. But tear, so that you are free from all past karmas. That's what we call karmakshaya. Annihilation of the past. Withdrawal of the past. So, this is all one aspect of doership. Am I clear? The same mind when turns inside, same mind. When it turns inside, what will it do? It is functionless. It is silent. It is passive. It is thoughtless. It is non-entity. Outer entity within non-entity. Passive, outer active. So this mind turned within gets absorbed into the self. Mind is the product of the self. Mind comes out of the self or Atma. Baba says it is the relationship between the father and the son. So mind itself gets withdrawn,
sunk into something like a pen that fits into. So mind gets sunk into the self. Then you are the witness. That is the answer. Thank you for your nice question. Next. It is a common scene in each and in every ashram, the living area of a deceased guru is freely available for anyone to enjoy. Here it is guarded by the police. What went wrong? A genuine question. I cannot simply brush it aside. The deceased guru, as you said, I beg to differ. Guru is never deceased. Body is deceased. And guru is not the body. Body is not the guru. So the place where body is laid to rest is a place of contemplation, not enjoyment. Here the question said, that place is available for anyone to enjoy. The place body is laid to rest is not to enjoy, but to contemplate, but to meditate. When you look at the cross, you don't enjoy the cross. Cross is a symbol on which Jesus Christ was crucified. Do you enjoy cross? No. You contemplate upon him. You think of his sacrifice. You think of his love. He thinks of the life that is shed for the love of mankind. We think of the bleeding blood which will cleanse all the sins of the vast humanity, then, now, and forever. So it is, they are all objects, they are centers for contemplation and not for enjoyment. It is guarded by police. It is guarded by police not for that particular place. They are guards to guard us, to protect us, not anybody. It is for the visitors. This guarding, this protection, this policing is for the pilgrims, is for the visitors, so that nothing would ever happen to them. But for Samadhi, police are not required. They can join Samadhi if they want. It's not that. So they are there to protect, for our protection, not for Samadhi. Well, that, with that, we come to a close of question answer session. I am really grateful, very grateful, thankful to all those that have sent these questions. And I think I could answer to the best of my ability and memory of Sai message. The areas where you are not satisfied with the answers, I beg of you to send questions again. You are questioning me, I'm answering you. You can question me again. Not necessarily that my answers are questionable. I don't say that my answers are unquestionable either. We are only seekers of truth. In these question answers, we are in search of the truth, which is all around. Therefore, I thank from the bottom of my heart all those that have sent forth these questions, both in person and by mail. Thank you very much. Om Samasta Loka Sukhino Bhavantu, Samasta Loka Sukhino Bhavantu, Samasta Loka Sukhino Bhavantu. Om Shanti.
Jai Bolo Bhagwan Sri Sat Sai Baba Ji Ki.
Jai.
जय बोलो भगवान श्री सच्चाई बाबा जी की, जय बोलो भगवान श्री सच्चाई बाबा जी की।
गॉड ब्लेस यू, थैंक यू। नेक्स्ट वीक
प्रॉब्ली 23rd, राइट, इट्स वेरी क्लोज टू दिवाली, द फेस्टिवल ऑफ लाइट्स, वी हैव फ्यू थॉट्स ऑन द सब्जेक्ट। थैंक यू वेरी मच।